Is it August 12th? Yes, worst sunburn ever. So the inside front cover is usually a typical theme. There are a couple of things I like to explore. One of them is this idea of personal temperature, based on where you were over the course of the year. What are the temperatures that you experienced? So I did this annual report of my life in 2005, where I sort of took an archaeological look at everything I'd done in the previous year, just scanning through my calendar and remembering the meaningful events, like the flights I took, and using Last.fm as a source. And I was able to put together this statistical view of my year, which I thought would be interesting to friends and family, and turned out to have a much broader appeal.
My first reaction when I first saw the Feltron report was, we don't care, do we? But you know, the thing is that it's more of an exercise in charting, and there's a great beauty in that, actually.
Okay, we have subway trips, 561. Foreign subway trips, 22. New York City taxi trips, 138. Foreign taxi trips, 13.
We don't care about his personal data, but actually, he treats the data with such a beautiful, precious way, and he does it so well. You can't help but like it.
He's right here. Teeth lost by a cat, 1. His canine on an unknown date.
I think it's great. I'm always excited to see what he comes up with. And I feel like it's also a reflection of how much data visualization is becoming a new expressive language.
His smartphone's pretty useful. Most of the time, it's not complex enough that I can't just write it down the next morning. iCal has been a great place to log things. And if things do get complex, like the year I was tracking every street that I walked down, there was a lot of smartphone typing it in and emailing it to myself. And then that one I would log in Illustrator. I would just draw the lines every day and make the map as I went. In a future that we're heading to where there are sensors everywhere and all this data is being produced, I feel I'm only, you know, a couple steps ahead of what will be done in an automated fashion for everyone.
The work that's being done now is kind of the first baby steps towards a world where it's not going to be really possible for you to have a major kind of, say, a cultural event without there being a corresponding kind of data visualization that goes along with it. We've been doing some work with MTV. What we put together was something that was looking again at Twitter traffic and the volume of Twitter traffic relative to the different stars that were at the Video Music Awards. You could start to do things like compare Taylor Swift to Kanye West.
Taylor Swift.
And those of you that pay attention to this kind of stuff probably know that he got up on stage and took her award away from her.
But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time.
But then immediately afterwards, we started to see this kind of result from Kanye West of what people were talking about. So this idea that you can kind of, again, you can set these structures up that kind of immediately, you know, tell you who the asshole is a pretty vital part.
So far, we haven't done much data gathering in the sense of dynamic real-time collection. Things like, can we look at every tweet on a topic? Or can we look at every tweet that comes across the wire and then see if we can figure out in aggregate what people are talking about? You know, the ability to see what 100 million people are having for lunch in any given moment may or may not be interesting, but when those people start going out into the real world and start experiencing things and twit-picking planes that land on the Hudson, then, you know, that all of a sudden you can make the case that that's compelling news information.
There's a number of graphics that we do that just automatically update themselves based on data feeds from like business services or election results. There's a couple challenges in it. One is just because something is dumped out in a data feed, once again, doesn't mean you necessarily want to just visualize that straight as is. You have to think, all right, is this something that really is worth taking the time to visualize and let it run on an updated basis? The second challenge is that when you're building something to just update itself, you need to build it in a way so that you handle all of the edge cases. So that if the unemployment rate comes in incredibly high 1 month, your chart still displays something normal and doesn't end up drawing off the chart.
There are certain aspects of live data that are really exciting and really interesting, but I think it's also like by necessity, by definition, it's here is some data, colon, right?
You could almost see breaking news stories appearing in a data set, and I think that would be probably a few years off, but that would be amazing if it happens.